morning.
Now, this is a shock. We've got an impressive young man in the studio.
Well, you do. I was driving through the city 2 days ago and I saw the protest, I guess you'd call it, on the corner of Collins and Swanston Street. Homeless people have set up a camp there, jumped out of my car, went and asked them a few questions and tried to find out what was going on. One of the things I learned, it's sort of to do with the Herald Sun's war on homeless people that's going on.
Which was basically initiated because of one photo of one aggressive guy who was wigging out a bit. Now, he doesn't speak on behalf of the homeless, but the Herald Sun decided that, yeah.
Not only that, it was,
they're all like
it was revolting of them to put his photo on the front page. This is a mentally ill person that you're just, you know, taking advantage of anyway. But what I found out, one of the many things I found out when I chatted with the homeless people in the city was that these days a lot of the assistance they get is from private people, is from members of the community who say, I don't know why no one's providing you with showers or no one's trying to help you clean your clothes.
Well, that's
or
the Australians
anything.
Of the year, aren't they? The
right.
guys who go around and wash clothes for the homeless.
So I'm just going to do something and make my life about that. Sean Thornton, you are one of those people.
Welcome.
Hello.
Thank you very much for having me.
You are Anonymous X.
Correct.
Okay.
Malcolm's brother.
Kind of. Is it true you sold your house to finance?
That's correct, yeah.
To finance your outreach?
Yeah, to basically fund the, well, we had initially had shipping containers and then we rented a warehouse in Oakley and we've just recently purchased a warehouse in Port Melbourne. Which,
okay, so that... I'm going to strip it back a bit for people who don't really know what you do, but you're a young man who decided something needs to be done about homeless. You don't, do you have any skin in this game? Were you homeless yourself?
I wouldn't say necessarily homeless for an extended period of time, but I've dealt with issues on the streets.
Right, you've had some hard times.
Yeah, absolutely.
Done well, bought a house and then gone, you know what? Nah, houses are more important for other people.
Yeah, I mean, my cousin unfortunately passed away in the flats in Flemington, and that in itself was, I guess, the initial reason why I wanted to go and create a change within people suffering on the streets.
Well, that reminds me of one of the major points that we've got going on here, where the mayor and the paper say there's no need for people to be homeless. There are rooms around Melbourne. There are places to stay. What I was told yesterday is that that circuit of boarding houses, rooming houses, commission flats is incredibly dangerous and actually more dangerous than living on the street.
It can a lot of the time.
Yeah, it can be. And then I guess you've got a whole bunch of people with a whole various reasons why they're homeless, and you put them all into this one place and expect them to get well in, you know, 4 to 8 weeks. If
there's tension, there's anger, there's theft, there's intimidation.
And a lot of them can't lock their doors. There's no sort of, I guess,
literally no locks on doors when you're paying bond and rent and you literally have no tenancy rights and you have no lock on your door.
Mm. And you're living maybe with an ice addict in the room next door who just needs money for his next hit. I wonder if you would say this, that most people's vision of the homeless is that if we can just get enough homes for them, they're all desperate to go into a home. Well, let's just fix it with that. I think, isn't homelessness not one story, but every homeless person is a different story?
Absolutely. I think to put them all into the same category is just extremely naive. And I think the media, or the newspapers recently anyway, have been very persuasive in the way that they're actually portraying the homeless people. And it's kind of collectively putting them all in this one category where they're all aggressive beggars, or they're all, you know, alcoholics, or they're all
some are mentally ill. Some are just people who've just, life has just moved away from them.
Well,
sadness.
I met a boy yesterday who grew up in a dysfunctional home. His parents were addicts, and then he was moved into foster care, in and out of foster care, and quite simply, at the age of 20, he's never been in a home. He doesn't understand how to set up a home. He doesn't know where to begin.
Look, it's extraordinary. I never get a met a homeless guy who was living back on the streets and using the money he would usually use for a guest house to build a fund for a prostitute he knew who had cancer and a four-year-old kid, and he was trying to just build a little support fund for when she dies, that the kid will have some money or something. Wow. So it's like it was actually by choice he moved to the streets as a money-saving option.
Yeah.
And no one would consider that after reading those Herald Sun stories.
No. Everything that's been printed in the last week or so has just been extremely frustrating, and I've been, I guess, writing my own article in my phone, and I'm finding the right time to post it. It's just negatively portraying people that I know personally and invested a lot of time in getting to know them individually, and it couldn't be further from the truth.
Have you met the mayor? He said he was going to come over and chat and had tried to. What happened there?
Last night he was at a council meeting down at the town hall. That was at, I think, 6:30 or 7:30 last night. So it was 15 minutes open for public speaking, and I sat in on that, and Mark Towler actually addressed a few issues with him. And I just think they're very, I guess the solutions that they've come up with has been a very...
It's very bureaucratic, isn't it, to have a council meeting? But I don't have any more questions, but your voice on radio is just delightful.
I tell you what, here's my final question. What can we do to help? And, I mean, you make sure that people have toiletries, food items, clothes and toys and all that. So can we donate that stuff to you? The collection points? How do we do that?
Well, we've got our warehouse in Port Melbourne, which is in Salmon Street, and we collect donations there. And essentially what we do is we collect donations, we categorise them, we sort them, and we distribute them. But we try and do it in a way where we dignify each individual. So we've got a clothing order form, and we have promise packs, and it's not just dropping off a whole bunch of donations. We cover people that are sleeping rough as well as people in crisis accommodation, so that when you've got people that are just really struggling on the street, they might get the opportunity to have temporary housing. Yep. And we'll try and help them there as well.
And it's simple stuff. Razors, deodorant, soap.
Yeah. Sanitary products for women, very important because they're very expensive.
Men's clothing as well, especially men. Okay, for some reason they donate and then that's off.
We will put all your links and everything on our Facebook page. Thank you so much. No, and we'll get some toiletries down there.
Awesome. You're a very inspiring young man, Sean Thornton. Thanks for coming in and sharing your time with us.
I appreciate it. Thank you.
It's 8:53 here on KISS.
Matt and Michelle.
KISS. You deserve to walk to the train in 5 minutes. You deserve to live at St. Genevieve at Diggers Rest.
Let's go!
Yes. Melbourne traffic.
Just in a pretty bad smash in Germana on Mornington Peninsula.